With the snap general election growing closer and closer, I went out and into Lansing to hear what residents had to say over the prospective candidates and to see which ones had made an impression. A constituency that has been conservative for decades, East Worthing and Shoreham is expected to remain the same this year. Tim Loughton has represented the constituency at Parliament since 1997, and we wanted to figure out what makes him so popular in the area.
I'm not sure how he does as a local MP, to be fair. I'm not a Tory, so I wouldn't necessarily support his policies on a wider national issues. But
No, he's a very good conservative person. That's who we vote for.
I know many, many people who would normally vote Labour who, you know, they can do what they like. It's a sort of secret ballot, isn't it? But they agree Tim Loughton is wonderful for the area. He's everywhere. He gives up all his time to it.
He is very interested in our community. So, yeah, that's lots of pluses on my part. But I don't like the Tory party.
One of Mr. Loughton's opponents this year is a brand new candidate. Sophie Cook, Labour, is the first openly transgendered candidate the country has seen. We asked voters if her campaign message is being picked up and if it's causing them to think along a new route.
Yes, I can't be doing with prejudice. I can't be doing with you're not like me, therefore I must, you know, harm you or send you away or make you unlawful. I think that's dreadful. I am a Green voter, I have to say. So I'm hoping there will be a Green candidate, because I think they're the only they have policies that I believe in.
I wasn't aware of that. Well, yeah, it's fine. Doesn't matter who is a candidate, really, as long as the policies are right. But I think the trouble is Labour is going to have, people don't really vote for the local candidate, sadly. People vote for leaders, and I don't know if that's necessarily going to do very well for Labour this time.
Voting for the Conservative will just make things more difficult. It won't make things better. So obviously people always like to a change, you know. So a change in, we put the country in the right position, which I think is the right thing to do.
I'm one of the 48%. So this election is very difficult for me because I don't think any of the parties really represent the 48%.
Yeah.
So it's going to be quite a difficult challenge. Obviously Labour is probably pro-Brexit. Tories are getting a very hard line. Lib Dem seem to be wavering a bit, so I guess Lib Dem, but it's a foregone conclusion, big Tory majority.
Me personally, I'm not going to vote. I haven't voted for quite some time because every time I voted, whether they got in or not, it's always been a very big disappointment. Nothing's changed. Or I say nothing's changed, beg your pardon. It has changed, but it's always for the worse. Yeah. All I can say is I might start voting again if an orangutan started to run for office. Then more than likely I'd vote for the orangutan, because if the orangutan made a mess of things, that's because it's an orangutan.
All jokes aside, there is clearly an issue. A number of voters do not see a candidate who best represents their ideals, and others have no faith in the promises sent their way. And some of those promises haven't even reached their audience.
So have you had much campaigning for this upcoming election?
No.
Nothing at all?
No. No, we've had nobody round.
Not even a leaflet?
Oh, we had leaflets.
Okay.
Leaflets, yeah, but nobody round to knock the door. Yeah, I don't think they do that nowadays.
It would be a tricky battle and surprising victory for the Lib Dems, Labour or the Green Party should they manage to unseat the Conservative majority in East Worthing and Shoreham. For latest TV news, Matthew Enderby.